Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to a virtual Abingdon Christmas. I'm Neil Brownless, Musical Director of Abingdon Concert Band. This has been a challenging year for music making, and I'm so pleased to see how everyone has adjusted to virtual performances, but we all can't wait to get back to rehearsals together to bring live concerts back to Abingdon soon. It's best to think of 2020 as a panto, because soon it will all be behind you. We open tonight's virtual concert with a performance we recorded back in the summer of Into the Unknown from Disney's Frozen 2, which is the one where Elsa goes to self-isolate on a glacier and Anna is in a tier 2 lockdown in the Enchanted Forest. We've recorded 3 brand new full band pieces for today's virtual concert over the last month, and also have 4 new recordings from smaller ensembles within the band. The concert should last just under an hour, so you'll still be able to catch the start of the Strictly final. Our next piece is one of our new full band pieces. It is a high energy arrangement of a popular Christmas carol, which has been put together by American concert band composer Richard Saucedo. This is Fantasy on Deck the Hall. With these virtual recordings, it's nice and easy if a piece of music's the same speed all the way through, so I thought I'd challenge our players with that piece, which had multiple tempos. While most of the band haven't been able to play with anyone else in person this year, one of our players moved back home during lockdown and so was able to play with her sister. Here we have Kate and Gemma Winfield playing a clarinet duet version of Dance of the Sugar Plum Fairy from Tchaikovsky's ballet The Nutcracker. Thank you. While you might not have been able to go on holiday this year, let's take you to the Caribbean for the next 5 minutes with the calypso-styled Mary's Boy Child. This song was originally written by Jester Hairston as a birthday song called He Pony and Chocolate Tea. Sometime later, Hairston was asked to write a Christmas song for a choir in Hollywood, and he kept the music of the birthday song and wrote new lyrics. Harry Belafonte heard the choir rehearsing the piece and loved it so much he asked if he could record his own version, which he did in 1956. This version is always a favourite of anyone playing bass clarinet in the band, so listen out for their calypso bass lines in this recording from our 2015 Christmas concert, which also has a solo from Sarah Cronin on the flute. We hope you enjoy Philip Sparks' arrangement of Mary's Boy Child. Thank you. I hope you're all shaking your maracas along to that one, like Chris in the chat. Mary and Joseph might struggle to make a 2020 Christmas. There's no Zoom at the inn. We've been meeting regularly as a band on Zoom for quizzes, desert island discs and general chats this year, and have managed to play some socially distanced quintets in the summer. We've also been able to get some small groups together for just two sessions of socially distanced carolling at Millet's Farm. Usually we're out carolling most weekends in December, collecting donations to cover our annual running costs, which continue even when we can't rehearse. With less people carrying cash and less carolling events, we're looking at a reduced level of donations this year. So we've set up an online donation platform. If you follow the link at the bottom of your screens or scan the QR code, you'll be able to go to the donation platform. Every little helps in ensuring we can bring live music back to Abingdon once restrictions end. Although we haven't been able to get together to rehearse since March, that hasn't stopped interest in joining the band from new players. Since the start of the first lockdown, we've gained a percussionist, a bassoonist and two trombonists. One of our new trombonists, who we've never actually met in person, has joined in with our next recording of a trombone quartet, which features myself, Becky Swanson, Walter Stewart Brown and Phil Cool. This is a fun little arrangement of the Ukrainian Carol of the Bells. I wonder if Carol of the Bells is what they call Quasimodo's wife. Now, Thomas is running our live stream this evening, and you may have noticed that Carol of the Bells started again there, and it's because his cat decided that you all wanted to hear it twice, so pressed a button on his keyboard. So thank you to the trombones of Abingdon Concert Band for that performance. We're now going to head back to our 2015 Christmas concert for our favourite pizza-loving king. And how does good King Wenceslas like his pizza? Deep pan, crisp and even. This jazz arrangement of the carol was created for the Count Basie Orchestra by Sammy Nestico. We feature the band's principal horn, Alistair Dorman-Smith, at the start of this version for concert band of Good Swing, Wenceslas.
Thank you.
During the summer, I had the ambitious plan of not only recording a brand new piece of music virtually, but also inviting musicians from around the world to play with us. I got to work writing the music, and once it was ready, we put out a call on social media asking for musicians to get involved. We had a fantastic response and received videos from 109 musicians from all over the UK, USA, Australia, Italy, Trinidad and Tobago, and we also had 10 musicians join us from the charity Brass for Africa in Uganda. In total, 71 ensembles were represented in the video. After about 3 weeks of video and audio editing, we were able to premiere the piece on the 19th of November. This piece is dedicated to all of the musicians around the world that, despite not being able to play together, have managed to keep the rhythm going.
Thank you.
I'm so amazed at the response that video has had, with over 6,000 views since it launched. We are planning another mass band virtual recording of a brand new arrangement for concert band from a composer of TV and film music who I've been speaking to over the last couple of weeks. I can now reveal the piece that we will be playing is the theme to the BBC adaptation of his Dark Materials, composed by Lorne Balfe. If you play a woodwind or brass instrument and would like to get involved, please email virtual@abingdonconcertband.org.uk. There are also parts for timpani and cymbals for any percussionists wanting to get involved. So from 109 musicians, we're now going to go down to just 5 with another new recording from a wind quintet of Abingdon Concert Band players. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. That was Sarah Cronin on flute, Mary Courtney on oboe, Kathy Wilcox on clarinet, Lucy Kettlewell on horn, and Will Granger on bassoon. It's certainly feeling a lot more like Christmas after that one. We're going to head back to our 2015 Christmas concert now for some Christmas film music from the 2004 film The Polar Express. This animated film tells the story of a boy who sees a mysterious train outside his house on Christmas Eve, and it's heading to the North Pole to see Santa before he sets off on his annual trip around the world. The film stars Tom Hanks voicing 6 of the main characters and has a score from the pen of Glenn Ballard and Alan Silvestri. This is Paul Lavender's arrangement for concert band of selections from The Polar Express. Thank you. It's time for something no Christmas concert is complete without. Heavy metal. And by that, I mean a load of tubas. We have a sextet of tuba and euphonium players for our next piece, which includes myself, Will Granger and Nicky Warden on euphonium, Phil Call, George Ryle and David Woodcock on tuba. We've recorded a song that was written during a really hot summer in an effort to cool down by thinking of winter. It started off with just four wintry things written on a page. Chestnuts roasting, Jack Frost nipping, Yuletide carols and folks dressed up like Eskimos. This is The Christmas Song. We're going to move on to another new full band recording now, with what was voted as the nation's favourite Christmas song in 2012. The song was started in 1985, but wasn't actually released until 1987. Despite the song's popularity, it has never reached the number one spot in the UK charts, and was kept to the number two spot when it was released by the Pet Shop Boys' Always On My Mind. I'm sure that will come up in a Christmas Zoom pub quiz. The band enjoyed playing this every Christmas. Feel free to get up and do an Irish jig with Fairy Tale of New York. Well, we've come to the final piece in our virtual Abingdon Christmas. If you've enjoyed this evening's performance, don't forget to donate at the link below or by scanning the QR code. All donations are gratefully received and help the band with their ongoing running costs. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Thomas Shepherd, who's been running the tech for tonight's live stream, Anna, who's been running the comments on the live stream on YouTube, and Will Granger, who edited all of the small ensemble videos. Thanks also to all of the band and our guest musicians who have put in the hours practicing and recording their parts at home. And lastly, thanks to all of you for tuning into our concert. We've had over 90 people tuning in live to watch the concert, which will be available to watch after we've finished later today. So we're going to leave you with another new recording of a piece that you can join in with at home. So if you get out your keys, you know, those things that you used to need when you left the house, you can jingle them like this, along with Sleigh Ride. Make sure to keep an eye out for our guest whipcrack players. From all of us at Abingdon Concert Band, have a Merry Christmas, and we hope it's not too long until we can see you in person again.